Say you've designed your robot, now you want to put a skin over his frame to make him look more lifelike and infiltrate the humans, become more accepted by humanity. A robot model typically has a few rigid elements that do not change over time, such as a forearm and an upper arm. At the joint, the objects are clearly separate. That's where you'd like to put skin. One simple solution is to just put some triangles connecting the two rigid pieces, sort of like a cylinder. As the joint bends, these triangles deform and stretch, keeping the two arm pieces attached. This doesn't look very good, as the more the arm bends, the more the joint flattens out. What we'd prefer is something more like a flexible tube that bends but mostly keeps its shape. Say we now add such a joint, with three cylinders one after the other. The challenge now is to how to move these cylinder vertices as the joint bends. The basic solution is surprisingly simple. Each vertex is assigned a weight. This weight is how much each rigid part's position affects the vertex. The top and bottom of the tube still stays connected to its rigid body part, so that body part's influence has a weight of 1. For vertices closer to the forearm, the weight is, say, 2/3 forearm, 1/3 upper arm. This modeling process of adding polygons and assigning weights is called skinning, or sometimes vertex blending. The rigid parts of the model are defined by bones. These bones are like a skeleton, so this whole area is sometimes called skeletal animation. As a bone moves, the skin is influenced by the bone's transform times its weight. Specifically, let's look at this one vertex on the skin that's near the forearm. The vertex location is transformed twice, once with respect to the forearm and once with respect to the upper arm. These two transformed locations are then multiplied by their corresponding weights, giving the interpolated point between them. The basic algorithm works fairly well, but can have problems. For example, in the inner part of the elbow, the points may bend inwards in an unconvincing way. In practice, a vertex can be influenced by more than two bones. The bones and weights are something the person modeling decides, and the weights always add up to 1. These characters were exported from Valve's Team Fortress 2 game and animated with 3JS's skinning class, called Skinned Mesh. Skinning is well suited to the GPU, as the vertex shader can transform points multiple times and add together the weighted locations. There are more elaborate algorithms that give better results, but for interactive rendering in particular, skinning is the mainstay.